Aniya. You awake, baby? You are mama? You wanna go home with your mommy or you wanna stay with me, baby? You wanna go home to your mommy? What you mean, no? Huh? What you mean, no? You wanna stay with me?
Yes.
You wanna stay with daddy?
Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
I love you. What? I love you more, honey. Daddy's a princess. Of course you can stay with me, mama. I want you to stay with me. I want you to come live with me, honey. You hear me? And daddy gonna make that possible. Believe that in Jesus' name. I'm gonna ask you one more time, okay? You wanna go home to mommy? You wanna go with me?
Yeah.
Okay, baby. You can come with daddy. I love you. This is my angel, man. I'm not forcing nothing on you, sugar. You know that. I'm glad you enjoy being with daddy. You can always come with me. You hear me? You hear me? Always be with daddy. So I'm gonna keep you with me tonight. We're gonna call mommy, let her know you stand with me, alright? Okay, baby. Daddy love you. Don't worry, mama.
Do you need an ambulance for, sir?
Yes, my daughter is having a hard time breathing. She's breathing, but she's young. She's barely breathing.
Is she able to talk in complete sentences?
No, she can't. She's not talking in no complete sentences at all.
How old is she?
4. She had fell out, and we just trying to see what's going on with her.
Is she conscious now?
Is she conscious? Yes. But she's not really breathing. She's not speaking. She's not speaking. She's not responding to us.
Is she awake?
Her eyes are open. Her eyes are open, yes.
But she's not really alert?
She's not saying anything or responding to our...
When I press down on her chest, she'll make a sound.
Okay. Well, don't press down on her chest, okay?
No, with 2 hands.
Does your daughter have a history?
Does she have a history of what?
Yeah, does she have a history of any breathing issues?
No.
What was she doing before this happened?
Well, she's been acting a little sick. We went to Red Lobster last week. I thought it was because of that, because she started acting weird. I thought it was like a stomach virus or something of what she ate or whatever. And I noticed as she's been at home, we started like feeding her and she was just throwing everything up. So gave her ginger ale, she threw the ginger ale up. I gave her Tylenol, she spit that up.
Okay. When's the last time she ate or drank anything?
We try to give her some breakfast in the morning, and she ate like a little bit of it, but it's like she kept chewing it. She was prolonged to chewing it for a long time.
She's been having these flu-like symptoms for how long?
It started last Thursday when we came for a lot, so we noticed she started acting weird.
Since last Thursday?
Yes.
As in like a few days ago?
Yes.
Has she been running a fever?
She was a little hot, but then her body would like just be weird to turn cold.
What is your name?
Aniya, A-N-I-Y-A.
What's your last name?
Day, D-A-Y.
Did you guys try contacting the child's pediatrician?
Did we try?
Yeah, did you call our pediatrician when this started?
No, I actually just spoke to a 24-hour nurse.
Okay. What is she doing now?
Well, now I just got her sitting up. I tried to even do mouth-to-mouth.
Well, if she's breathing, you probably don't need to do CPR. Do you know what I'm saying?
Because I'm just trying to figure out what else can I do. Like, I put my hands up to her nose to see if she was breathing, and I didn't feel no air coming out. Like, she got her eye open.
Wait a minute. Is she not breathing?
No.
Your child is not breathing?
No.
Okay, let's do CPR then.
That's what I'm trying to do. I didn't do my whole force two hands. I just... Two fingers, basically, is what I'm doing.
Okay, I want you to get her on a flat surface, okay?
Okay, say it again.
No. They just told me, yes, we're going to start CPR right now.
Okay, put the phone on speaker,
okay? If you guys have an AED available, I want you to send someone to go get it right now, okay?
What available?
An AED machine?
No, we don't have that.
All right, place your daughter flat on her back on the floor, okay?
Okay.
Kneel down near her chest.
More on her stuff on her back.
She is definitely not breathing, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Place the heel of your hand in the center of her chest.
Mm-hmm.
Put your other hand on top of the first hand. I want you to push down firmly on the chest at least 2 inches, only to the heel of your hands. Okay? We're going to do it 30 times, just like you're pumping her chest, okay? You're going to count out loud with me. Are you ready?
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. We're going to keep going, okay? Hard and fast, okay? She starts breathing, okay. Then we're going to stop. We're going to keep doing this. Keep going. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Keep going, okay? The squad just called that they're unseen. I need one of you guys to get up and go open the door. Okay?
Okay, down there now.
Is she still not breathing?
Yeah, she make a sound whenever we do that, whenever we, you know, you do the little pumping thing. She made a sound like a,
but then is she breathing? Check her nose. Somebody should still be pumping.
You feel cold air. Yes, you feel cold air coming out the nose.
There's cold air coming out of the nose?
Yes.
Okay, if she's got air coming out, is her chest rising up and down?
No.
Her chest is not. All right, keep pumping. Okay, if her chest isn't going up and down, I want you to keep going until the squad gets started to take over. Okay? I'm going to count with you again. Let me know when the squad opens the door. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
What? The paramedics are here now.
All right. Let them take over, okay?
All right.
Thank you.
Okay. 23-year-old Sierra Day and her live-in boyfriend, 26-year-old Deontay Lewis, are hauled into court to face a charge of aggravated murder for causing the death of Sierra Day's daughter, 4-year-old Aniya Day Garrett. The medical examiner says Aniya was beaten to death and was malnourished at the time of her death.
Satan, the devil, I cannot imagine to tell you why someone would hurt a child.
The child's father, Michael Garrett, says his daughter had been abused over and over again by her mother. He and other family members reported the abuse to Cuyahoga County Children and Family Services on a number of occasions. And at the time of Aniya's death, he was fighting for emergency custody.
Yeah, I did everything in my power to let them know, you know, that I was a stand-up dad and that my daughter was being harmed and abused at home. And this was an emergency.
The anguish over losing his daughter and the anger of coming face-to-face with the two people accused of killing the child boil over. Michael Garrett says he is overwhelmed by the knowledge that no one was there to protect Aniya.
They did absolutely nothing to help my daughter in this situation, and now my daughter's dead.
A teacher at a daycare center in Euclid tells Fox 8 News that she reported on at least four different occasions that Aniya was being abused by her mother.
So I'm asking Aniya what happened, and she said, "Mommy hit me, but Mommy said I fell."
Michelle Marshall says she filed incident reports each time Aniya showed outward signs of abuse, first bruises and then black eyes.
Mom hit me. Mommy did it.
What is most frustrating to Michelle Marshall and everyone else who loved Aniya Day Garrett is that authorities failed to take action, even after it was reported that Sierra Day pushed her daughter down a flight of stairs and later punched her in the head.
Aniya fought for herself. She told the police, "Mommy hurt me. Mommy did this. Mommy hit me." She told the doctor. She told the social service lady. They failed her. Child Family Services failed her.
Jack Shea, Fox 8 News in Euclid.
Well, new details on the death of 4-year-old Aniya Day Garrett. Police reports show the little girl suffered years of abuse before she died, and Child and Family Services knew about it.
Shelby Miller spoke with one of the women who reported Aniya's abuse to police. Shelby, what did she tell you tonight?
Yeah, I sat down with Tamika Robinson, a worker at Harbor Crest, which is where Aniya went to daycare for years. Tamika tells me Aniya came to daycare beaten, bloodied, and bruised. At one point, the 4-year-old had to be rushed to the ER. Tamika reached out to police and told them about that abuse. She says the system failed this innocent child.
Police dash cam footage captures paramedics rushing little Aniya Day Garrett's lifeless body into the back of an ambulance Sunday. The 4-year-old had been hit in the head, burned, and nearly starved before she died.
Your child is not breathing?
No.
Aniya is gone, and she's never coming back. Never coming back.
This was Tamika Robinson's worst fear. She works at Harbor Crest in Euclid, where Aniya went to daycare. She says the 4-year-old was sweet and playful, but also shy. It was clear she longed to be loved.
And her hug wasn't a soft hug. It was a very compassionate, strong hug that she'll hold you at least 2 minutes before she let go.
Tamika believed the little girl was being abused by her mom, Sierra Day. She says the toddler came to daycare with bumps, cuts, and bruises.
And I was like, "Aniya, what happened to your face? Oh, my God." And she was like, "Mommy pushed my face in the carpet, but Mommy said I fell at the park." 3 days later, Aniya walks in the door. Aniya has 3 lumps in her head with blood clots in them. Aniya is bleeding from her ear.
May 18th, 2017, Aniya was rushed to the hospital. That's the same day Tamika handed over more than a dozen abuse reports to Euclid Police and Cuyahoga County Child and Family Services.
I gave everything to the police that they needed to know that Aniya had been being abused for a long time.
Police say a social worker reviewed it and closed the case 6 weeks later, leaving the little girl with her mom. Tamika says the state needs to work harder to protect children like Aniya.
You can never take a child willingly, but this one child I wish I would have took and suffered the consequences.
This Euclid police report right here shows 14 serious abuse allegations, and in more than half of them, Aniya says her mom hit her. Since getting my hands on this report this afternoon, I reached out to Child and Family Services multiple times, and they have not returned my calls or my emails.